Welcome back. Real estate expert Andrew Haddad is from Keller Williams, and he's back today with fixing and flipping homes. Now, this is near and dear to me because I've been harassing you about this.
I've been trying to find
So tell me why, you know, what are some of the dangers that come with this?
Sure. Well, you know what? I'll tell you what. You got to leave it to the professionals because, I mean, there are a lot of risks involved, but the benefits far outweigh the risks across the spectrum. Oh. I mean, neighbors don't want to look at, you know, dilapidated foreclosed homes. You know, consumers like myself that did buy one of these houses, I have a baby at home. I don't have time to fix up the house. So it is a benefit all across the spectrum, especially the ones we see. They've done such a good job, and they use quality products. They do a great job, and they make the house ready move-in for the family.
Oh, but it can be so expensive to fix one up.
It
more
is.
Than you think, maybe.
Absolutely. I always, you know, the rule of thumb is always overestimate.
Yeah.
Because you never know with some of the houses
what
that have been sitting for so long.
Well, let's take a look at some of the...
Perfect. All right, this first house is in Venice. This was bought for $102,000. These are the before pictures. So, as you can see, it hasn't been touched. This was a bank-owned house, was sitting for a long time. The pool has, you know, is in terrible condition.
It's green.
Yep, that's green. And then they flipped this house. They fixed it up. This is now sold for $195,000. Brand new roof, Brazilian granite, Brazilian floors, completely redone. $195,000 for pretty much a brand new house in Venice.
Oh, wow.
That's a great deal.
But how much did it cost to fix it up?
This one was done by James Atkins, Atkins Ford Group. He averages about $50,000, $50,000 to $60,000 that he puts into the house. And he, you know, he says he can do these in 90 days.
So he makes $25,000.
About 25% is the return on investment.
That's pretty great.
But he did, this wasn't the homeowner that bought it that did it. He did it as an investment.
He did it, yep.
Absolutely. And he knew what he was doing.
And he knew what he was doing, yeah.
So the next one.
Perfect. And the next one right now, we are going to Bradenton. These are the before pictures. Again, a house that needs so much work. This was purchased for $130,000. As you can see, it's very cut up. Hasn't been touched. The electric wasn't on. Needs to be completely redone. The after pictures are here. Now, it has been redone.
They cleared the trees.
Yeah.
Brand new kitchen,
top line,
brand new floors. It does not look like the same house.
Oh, that's what I was going to say.
This is a ready move-in. This is available for sale for $215,000
right now. So, wow, look at the difference
the difference in how much the value goes up. Absolutely.
Yeah.
This next house, this is right in Sarasota. This house, again, was a bank-owned house. Has been sitting for a while, you know. My wife and I actually bought this house after it was redone, so I'll show you that.
Did you want the title?
So you saw the potential.
I saw the potential.
There you go.
But here it is
now.
Fully redone.
Wow.
Area. I mean, they picked up that house.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's beautiful. Brand new wood floors,
pool,
everything. So you can see, like a consumer now, I can go into a new house and it's ready move-in.
That's amazing.
All the work.
Wow, look at that. It's an oasis.
Okay, so here's the question.
Yeah.
Where do you get the vision? Because if I went into a home like the first one,
and
I looked at that, I would never see what the end result was.
I gotta tell you, it's an art. I couldn't do it myself to be able to go in and see the house in its current condition and not only project the cost, but be able to have that vision to see what it can become and sell for.
And how to cut the inserts and all those things that they did.
Absolutely.
Remove walls.
Yeah. The next one we're gonna go to is, again, this is in Sarasota. This house was sitting for a very long time. This was a foreclosure house. They picked this house up at $130,000. Had to be completely gutted. These are the before pictures. Right off Beaver Road, great location. They turned this house into, this is a five-bedroom, five-and-a-half bath. There's a main house, there's two apartment studios, but it's been completely redone. Brand new 50-year model roof, brand new upgraded flooring, painted on the inside.
How cute.
All the bedrooms and baths have been redone. Mm-hmm. It is on the market right now for $325,000. Yeah.
Oh, that's a big difference.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Look how light and bright it is with those windows.
Yeah. And then the next house, we're going to go back up to Bradenton. This is actually right next to the IMG Academy. This house was purchased for $180,000. This was a bank-owned, three-bedroom, two-bath.
Those are my questions.
This was actually the kitchen, how it was left. But look at the
Too bad, but...
This was completely redone. That's before picture. Now it's been redone. So we have a new roof, this house, new plumbing, new electricity. You're gonna see they took down a bunch of walls. They totally modernized the house.
The lighting is all redone.
Oh, wow. Looks like a bathroom.
It is, yeah. Beautiful master bath. This actually sold for $360,000.
Amazing.
So, but again, great location, everything.
Yeah, so it's just about the vision, really. And I grew up like this, so I know exactly what you mean. My dad did this to all of our houses, so we've seen a transformation. I can walk into a house and be like, oh, dad will completely gut out the whole thing. So now I'm used to that, so I can find a husband that
is in Sarasota.
Gorgeous.
This was actually completely done from top to bottom. This is right on Siesta Key. This did sell for $7 million. This is a Bruce Savick custom home. I mean, where do I start? Five bedrooms, five baths, 7,100 square feet. It's directly on the beach.
Oh my goodness.
You got your private beach. I mean, this house is absolutely amazing. Sunsets every night.
So was this one of the ones that were fixed and flipped, or was
this one was actually they completely rebuilt from the ground floor. This was a spectacular
rebuild.
Yeah,
brand new.
Brand new.
Right for me to move in.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we're gonna wait.